My name is Haseena. Today I'll be presenting about the event scheduling algorithm using checkout counter. Now the given question is, prepare a simulation table for a single channel queue using an event scheduling algorithm until clock reaches 23 using inter arrival time and service time given below. Stopping event of the system will be at time 60. Now let us consider the given table. IAT inter arrival time is 1163752 and service time is 4254154. Now to do a simulation table, let us consider the given table below. Let us consider the following simulation table, that is clock time, and LQ of T is a number of events waiting in the queue, LS of T number of events in the server, checkout time, future event list, comments, and the following cumulative statistics, that is B, M, Q, S, N, D, and F. B is a server busy time, M, Q, S is the sum of customer response time for all the customer who has departed at the current time. ND is the total number of departure up to current simulation. And F is the total number of customers who spend 5 or more minutes in the system. Now let us consider the clock time 0. At clock time 0, no server will be waiting in the queue. And one event will be given a service. So the checkout time will be C1, 0. The future event list will be arrival of the first event, arrival of second event at 1, because inter arrival time is 1. So arrival of second event at 1, departure of the first event at 4, that is 4 + 0 = 4, and then exit time is 60. Okay. That we have to write the comment C1 arrives, then A star is equal to 5, that is event arriving for C2, and S star is equal to 4, event departure for C1. Now at the initial stage, the cumulative statistics will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 for everything. See, now from the first table, we have got inter arrival time is less, that is 1. Let us consider 1 as the next clock time. At 1, already the service will be given for C1. So the event C2 will go to the queue and 1 will be given service. Now we have C1, 0 and C2, 0 in the C2, 1 in the queue, that is checkout time. Next, future event list will be arrival of the third event, because already second event has been arrived, and then departure of the fourth event will be same, I mean first event will be same, and then ending time is 60. Now in comments, what we have to write is C2 has already arrived at time 1, C2 arrived, and A star is equal to 1, that is arrival for C3. Now to calculate the value of B, let us see the previous LQ of 0. LQ of 0 is 0. So it is 1 - 0 + 0. So it will be 1 only. MQ will be 1 + 0 - 0. So it will be 1. As of now, no event has been departed. So it will be 0, 0, 0. Now let us consider the next event, that is at 2. 2 we have to take as a clock time. At 2, what will happen is already the service is given for the 1, it is not yet completed. 2 is in the queue, 3 will arrive, so both 2 and 3 will be in the queue. Service will be given for 1. So in the queue we have C1 at 0, C2 at 1, and C3 at 2. Now next, C3 has arrived, so we have to write arrival of 4, that is event 4 at what time? 2 + 6, so it will be 8. 2 + 6 will be 8. So at 8, C4 will be arriving. Departure of 1 is not yet happened, so D, 4, C1, and ending time is 60. Now we have to write C3 is arrived. C3 arrived, and A star is equal to 6, that is event arrival for C4. Next, to calculate B, let us see. Now the one server is being served. So the answer for B will be 2 - 1 = 1. So it will be 2. Now as of now, the maximum length of the queue is 2. So this will be 2. Now there is no event departed, so it is 0, 0 and 0. Now among this future event list, the minimum clock time is given for a 4. So let us take the clock time as 4. At the time 4, C1 will be departing. So the next event will be arriving at 8. So the queue length will decrease 1, that is 2 will be given service and 3 will be in queue. Now let us see which and all are there in queue. C2 at 1. C3 at 2, these are the events in the queue because C1 has already departed. Now let us write the next future event list, that is A, arrival of C4 at 8 and next departure of C2. The service time given for C2 is 2. So the C2 will arrive at 1, right? So 4 plus service time is 2, right? 4 plus 2 is 6. So C2 will be departing at 6. Then ending time is 60. Now we have to write C1 departs and then SS star, the service time given for second event is 2, that is the event of departure for C2. Next we have to calculate the bus busy time and the future. Now busy time, you have to see LS of T is 1 for the previous event, so it will be 4 minus 2 plus 2, that will be 4, and then maximum length of the queue as of now is 2. Now since one event has been departed, now we have to calculate the value of S, N, D and F. Now 1 has been departed, the total service time given for 1 is 4, it has arrived at 0. So the total time spent by the event 1 is 4 minutes, that is 4 minus 0 in the server, so it will be 4. The total number of event departed is 1. Since the time spent by event 1 is 4 minutes, it is not more than 5, so the value of F will be 0. See, next for the next event, let us see the future event list. Now the minimum value is 6, so let us take clock time as 6. At 6, departure of C2 will happen, so the server will be 0 here, the waiting will be 0 and 3 will be given service. At time only C3, 2 will be there in the checkout counter. Now departure of arrival will be same, we have to calculate the departure of C3, that is C3 is given service at time 6, the service time for 3 is 5 minutes, so 6 plus 5 is 11, so departure will be D, 11, C3, ending time is 60. Now we'll write C2 departs, S star is equal to 5 for event C3. Next we have to calculate the value of B. B, you can see here, this is 1, so 6 minus 4 plus 4 will be 6 itself. The maximum length of the queue till now is 2. Now we have to calculate the value of this. Now you can see the service time is given 5. Now to calculate the value of S, let us see the total time spent by C2 in the system. C2 has arrived at 1 and departed at 6. Total time spent by C2 is 5. So 5 for C2 and C1 has spent 4 minutes. So the total value will be 9. So S will be 9. Now the number of elements departed is 2. Because C1 has departed and C2 has departed, so total 2 event has been departed. Now what is the value of F? Since the event 2 has spent 5 minutes in the 5 seconds in system, so it will be 1, because one event has been more than equal to or more than 5 minutes in the system. Now for the next event, let us see among the future event list, 8 is very less. So 8 is a clock time. At 8, the C4 will be in the system, but C3 is being served. So it will be in the queue and C3 is given service. So C3 at 2 and C4, 8. Next, the future event list will be arrival of the fifth event, that is at what time? 5 will arrive at 3. See, this is for 5, it will arrive at 3. It will arrive at 8, clock time 8. So 8 plus 3 is 11. 11 is at C5 will arrive at 11. So departure will be same for C3. Ending time will be 60. Okay. Next, let us write C5 arrives as a future event and A star is equal to 3. For C5. Next, we have to calculate B and S. B, you can see, LS of T is not 0. So, 8, LS of 0 is not 0. So, 8 plus 6, 8 minus 6 plus 6, that will be equal to 8. Now, that maximum length of Q is 2. Since no event has been departed in this particular clock time, the value remains same, 921. See, now, seeing the future event list, the clock time minimum is 11. So, let us take next clock time as 11. At a time 11, C3 will depart and C5 will depart. So, and C4 is being served. So, C5 will come in the queue and C4 is being served. Checkout time will be C4,8 and C5 will be arriving at 11. C3 is departed. Future event list is, we have to calculate the arrival of the next event, that is C6. At time level, the arrival time of 6 is 7. So, 7 plus 11 is 18. So, A,18,C6. Arrival of 6 will be at 18. Next, departure of the fourth event, we have to calculate. The service time given for 4 is 4. So, 11 plus 4. Departure will be 11 plus 4 is 15 for C4. Ending time E is 60. So we have to write C3 departs and C5 arrives in the comment. Next, we have to calculate the value of B. Since it is 1, it is 11 minus D plus 8. 11 minus 8 plus 8. So it will be 11. It remains 11. The maximum length of the queue is 2 itself. Now we have to calculate the value of S. To calculate the value of S, the previous value for 1 and 2 was 5 plus 4. Now we have to calculate how many times the event 3 has spent in the system. 3 has arrived at time 2 and it has departed at the time 11. So 11 minus 2 will be 9. So 9 plus 9 is equal to 18. So the value of S will be 18 here. Now the value of 9 will be 18. Now total... So, till now, the total number of events that has departed is 3. That is C1, C2, C3. So, ND will be 3. The events which has spent more than 5 minutes is 2 and 3. So, that will, the value of F will be 2. See, the next, now we have to see the future event list. 15 is the minimum time. Next will be at 15. At 15, C4 will depart. So, nothing will be there in the queue. C5 is being served. So, we have to write C5,11. C4 is departed. So, checkout line will have only C5 and 11. Now, arrival will remain same, A,C6. We have to calculate the arrival of the departure of the 5. That will be the service time given for 5 is 1. So, it will arrive at 15. It will arrive at 15, right? So, it will be 15 plus 1, 16. That is departure of C5. Ending time is 60. Next, we have to write here, C4 departs. And service, we have calculated S star is equal to 1 for C5. Next, we have to calculate the value of BMQ, cumulative statistic. B will be 15 minus 11. That is 15 minus 11 plus 11 will be 15 itself. The maximum length of the queue will be 2. Till now, only it has gone up to 2. And then we have to calculate the value of S. The previous value of S was 18. The minutes C4 has spent in the system is, it has arrived at, C4 has arrived at 8 and departed at 15. So, it has spent 7 minutes. So, 18 plus 7, that is equal to 25. Now, the number of events departed is 4 till now. And the events that have spent more than 5 minutes is 3, because it is 2, 3 and 4. The next time will be 16. At 16, C5 will be departing. So, nothing will be there in the queue and nothing will be given services. So, here checkout counter will be nothing. So, arrival is 18 for C6. Then we have to calculate the departure. No, we don't have to calculate the departure because there is nothing has C5 is departed and C6 has not yet arrived. Ending time will be 60. Same. Now, we will have to write C5 departs. Now, we have to calculate the value of cumulative statistics. So, it is 16 minus 15 plus 15 will be 16 itself. So, maximum length of the queue is 2. Now, we have to calculate how much the C5 has spent in the system. C5 has occurred at 11 and it is going at 16. So, it has spent only 4 minutes. Therefore, 4 minutes. So, So 5 minutes. So it is 25 plus 5. That is 30 total events spent in the system. Now till now, how many events have departed? 5 events, and the value of F will be 4. So the next clock will be 18. At 18, C6 will arrive. So Q nothing will be there, and LS will be 6 will be given services. At this time, at checkout counter, it will be C6 comma 18. Next, we have to calculate the arrival of the next event, that is 7th event. A comma 18 plus inter arrival time for 7 is 5. So 18 plus 5 is 23 comma C7. Next, departure of C6, we have to calculate. The service time given for C6 is 5 minutes. So, we have to take 18 plus 5, that is A, 23, that will be departure of C6, and ending time will be 60. Now, comment is C7 arrived. Okay. Next, we have to calculate the cumulative statistics. In while calculating the cumulative statistic, we have to see here if the value is 0. So, what is happening is the value of this will remain the same, since that nothing has given service at the previous. The maximum length will be Q. So, all the cumulative value will be same, since the previous value of LS of T is 0. Now, let us take the next clock cycle. Next will be 23. At 23, C7 will arrive and 6 will be departing. So, nothing will be there in the queue, and 7 will be given service. Now, we have to write C7 at 23. Now, we have to calculate the arrival event for the next one. That is, that will be given as 2 minutes. So, we have to write 23 plus 2. A is 25 for C8. And departure is, total service time given for 7 is 4. So, D, 23 plus 4 is 27, departure of 7. So, E, 60. Here what happens is, C6 departs and C8 arrives. Now, let us look at the value of cumulative statistics. Here the value is 1. So, 23 minus 18 plus 16 will be 21. And maximum length of the queue is 2 itself. Now, the time spent by 6th event in the system is 23 minus 8, that is 5 minutes. So, 30 plus 5 is 35. And here the element that has departed is 6. 6, and here it will be 5, because C2, C3, C4, C5 and C6 have spent 5 or more than 5 minutes in the system. Since 23 is a stopping time given, we have to stop the simulation table here. Now, after stopping the simulation at 23, let us calculate the following items. That is, the average response time. The average response time is given by S divided by ND. Now, what is the value of S? The value of S is 35 from the simulation tables. That is, 35 divided by ND value is 6. So, 35 divided by 6 will be 5.83 minutes. Next, we have to calculate the total, the proportion of the customer who spent 5 or more minutes in the system. The formula for that is F divided by ND. From the simulation table, the value of F is 5 and the ND value is 6. That is 5 divided by 6, 0.83. So, this is how the sum is done with checkout counter.